right, what's going on, everybody? So today I'm going to install the FASS fuel system. I ordered the 150 GPH. Also, I'm going to do an install with the Sump. Okay, so I paid overall $611 free shipping on eBay. I'll leave the link in the description where I bought it from. But it came with a free Sump, so I might as well go ahead and do that too. I've been wanting to do a Sump kit anyways. But for those of you guys that don't really know what a Sump actually is, what it does is it sucks the fuel from underneath the bottom of the tank instead of actually drawing the fuel from the top, from that actual straw, where your CP3 has to suck that fuel into the engine, okay? So basically what that tank or that Sump does in that tank is it's gravity fed. So it's gonna put less wear and less pressure on your lift pump and your CP3. And also for some of you guys that have those quarter tank issues, where you know your truck won't run after once you hit a quarter tank, you don't have to worry about that no more. Basically what I'm saying is it'll use every last drop, and it's ultimately good for you. And the FASS system in itself, or just a lift pump in general, if you guys decide that this is something you want to do, the biggest reason why I'm doing this is because I want to eliminate the water, the air, and the dirt going into my injectors. Thus, the diesel engine running a lot better, a lot cleaner, burning more efficient. Better fuel economy, better horsepower, I guess. I don't know if that's the case or not. We'll find out. You know, throttle response, cleaner injectors, and obviously not making your CP3 work so hard to pull that fuel from the top of the tank into your engine, okay? So that's why I'm doing this. I think it's a great thing. The biggest concern of mine is when I'm driving down the road, now that I have, you know, the EFI Live, I actually have the intake, the exhaust, the built transmission, and I don't think my CP3 is catching up with the fuel. I really don't. So I want to maintain rail pressure. That's important as well. So I'm trying to speak in sort of newbie terms for some of you guys that understand this, because it took me a while to learn this too, guys. So don't worry about it. But overall, hey, look, guys, watch the video from start to finish. This video that I'm posting, my goal for this video is for it to be the best lift pump installation video on YouTube. I'm telling you guys right now, I am having a hard time trying to find a lift pump video that will show you from start to finish every little step. So yes, I'm going to be very detailed. I want you guys to watch every bit of it, okay? So if you have any questions, obviously, you know, leave them in the comments. I'll make sure I get back with you. And this is your first time, you know, watching my channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Now this will actually go for an 01 to a 2010. So if you guys, for you LB7 guys, this is a must for you LB7 guys, by the way, for your injectors. But LB7s, LOYs, LBZs, LMMs, okay? This is actually the target. This is the how-to for this guide right here. Now, you know, if you have a different model than me, I have an LBZ, it will be a little different. But hey, look, guys, if you're watching this and you guys own a Cummins or a Power Stroke, hey, don't worry about it, man. The process is going to be very similar as well. So make sure you guys stay tuned. All right, guys, so let's get to the unboxing here. And I went ahead and just pre-cut the tape. So you're going to have your instructions. Looks like you're going to have your wiring harness for your relay and all that. It goes to your fuse box, all your fuel lines, your bag hardware, which we'll go into, sweet sticker that adds like 15 horsepower. All right, this packing's pretty good actually. Looks like it comes with your two brackets. And last but not least, it's assembled, which is pretty cool. It's not all assembled. You're gonna have to put your fittings in there, but they screwed on your filters, so that's pretty neat right there. All right, so let's get started. Okay, guys, so first what you're gonna wanna go ahead and do is just take off the filters, just because they're gonna be in the way. And obviously note, you know, which side the water separator is versus the fuel filter. Okay, now we have these off. All right, guys, go ahead and pull off these little covers or caps or whatever that are inside your pump. Okay, next, so go ahead and take this fitting right here. And you're going to want to go ahead and just use some threading tape or Teflon tape or whatever. And note, this is not going to screw into the pump. This side right here with the flat piece, as you can tell, that's going to go upward. So it's going to go in like that, not in like that, okay? That's the correct orientation. Just make sure you guys don't miss that step. Okay, so I got that done, and I'm gonna do this one too. This thing's gonna go on the other side of the pump. Okay guys, just like that, okay? Now what I'm gonna go ahead and do now is just put it in the vise and tighten these fittings up right here. Okay guys, make sure you put it inside the vise because in the instructions it says that you can't tighten these up like let me show you. Just like that. That's improper, so it can't be, you know, laying on the side while you're trying to screw the fittings down with a ratchet. You want to make sure that it actually goes inside of a vise. So that's what I'm doing right now. And this one right here, this will be a 22 millimeter right here. I'm not gonna crank her down too tight though. This is the other side of the pump, and this is supposed to orient upward. There's like a little mark right there where you can kind of line it up as well. Guys, so we're gonna go ahead and install this part right here to the neck now, but just make sure that this spout is facing out towards the truck, okay? Because this way, the way it's oriented, I'm on the driver's side, back rear, and this is facing outside of the vehicle. So just understand that. You don't want to put it backwards or whatever, because it's obviously not going to do anything. So let's go ahead and get this thing in there. Okay, after you're done with that, go ahead and tighten your clamps down. All right guys, note orientation, okay, on how this is actually placed. Okay, so you're gonna have one up here on the top, one here on the bottom, and then this one's gonna kind of, this bolt hole's actually up just a little bit, just a hair. So you're gonna wanna go ahead and place your spacers over there, and then, the four bolt holes right here on the bottom, right there, that's going to be bottom, you know, of the pump itself. And then the orientation of this is going to go towards the right of the 90 degree fitting. All right, so go ahead and put your bolts through, line it all up. And this will be 11 millimeter. Since you already have this off right here, you know, it's not mounted obviously yet. Make sure you tighten these bolts down. There's no reason to keep these loose. Okay, so 11 millimeter. Surprisingly, they didn't give you washers for this kit on this end. I was thinking about throwing some washers on there, but I'm sure it'll be fine. Okay, so we're good to go there. So let's mount the bracket that goes to the bed this time. But as you guys can see, the orientation of that, as you can see right there. All right, let's keep moving. All right, guys, so what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna use this first bolt closest to the cab, obviously, that's hooked up. Right here, let me show you. So there's the seam of the cab and the bed going downward. All right, guys, in my case, I'll be using an 18 millimeter. Alright, just like that. And then next, we're going to go ahead and mount this. We're going to use that existing bolt. And we're going to stack this pad right on top of it, just like that, okay? This isn't metal, this is actually just a flimsy piece of rubber. But we're going to go ahead and mount. The way we're going to do this is we're going to put that old bolt that we just zipped out. We're going to put it through here and just simply mount it right back up into place. So let me show you. All right, guys, remember, this 90 degree elbow is going to face outward this way, so not inward, because it wouldn't fit it. Well, it might, no, it wouldn't fit anyways. So let's go ahead and get this thing on there. Pretty strong, actually. It's on there pretty good. All right, let's go back to the pump. Okay, guys, so next what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna go ahead and prepare four of these bolts here with the washers. Simply drop them through just like that. Okay. And then right behind it, we're going to put that, with the kit, it's going to come with that other rubber piece. It seems like when you slide these around, it gets a little bit tighter when you go this way. I'm sure there's a reason for that. Okay, so here's the rubber footing piece that you're going to want to go ahead and attach to it. And then you're going to have your bolts. There's going to be four of them. And it'll be a 14 millimeter. All right, so let's go ahead and get this mounted. Let me show you how to do this. So remember, these bolts are going inward like that. Okay, not opposite, so. It's kind of loose, just for now. Actually, they're going to be loose the entire job until the very end, just in case there's any way I can possibly slide this thing somewhere different. Because to be honest with you guys, I don't really like the look of the lift pump filters completely under, you know, where you can actually see all the filters. I like them tucked. Problem is, I'm going to have that fill tube right there. It shouldn't be a problem. But that's where I'm going to want it. It's as high as possible is where I'm going to want this thing. Okay, so I didn't tighten all the bolts completely yet. Still playing with it, but as you can see, there's a straw, and that's exactly how you mount it, just like that. You're getting a better angle of this. I'm trying to help you guys out, man. So it's crushing that tube right there. I don't really like that, but shouldn't be a problem. All right, so let's keep moving. All right, so I just screwed the filters on. For now, I'm gonna take them back off, but doesn't look too bad. Looks pretty cool. I actually like it. I like where it's positioned. So good stuff. All right. So now, time to run the. I'm gonna go ahead and do the wiring. So make sure you guys buy extra zip ties, because you'll be using a lot of them. Just for that, you know, clean look. And obviously, you don't want any wires rubbing on any metal pieces or anything like that. Last thing you need is to ground something out, so. Okay, so you're gonna have your relay. you're gonna have your negative and positive. Your positive is gonna be your red, and then your negative is gonna be the green. And they suggest that you run this straight to your batteries or your battery, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm actually gonna run it. I'll show you guys where I'm gonna run it. I don't want to run anything to into my batteries. I already got a light bar ran to it, so last thing I need is extra stuff to be plugged in there. So looks like a little module. This is the clip that goes to your fuel pump, and then this is going to your fuse box right there. So okay, guys. So first, what you're gonna want to go ahead and do is it already came pre-spliced, so you're gonna want to go ahead and take your connector. Take this off, obviously. This again, this all comes with the kit. And push it through, and then you're gonna simply crimp it in. Okay, I'm just gonna use some vice grips. Work. Okay, so we're in business. Okay, and this is the red wire right here, the single red wire that will actually go to your fuse box. So let's go ahead and get that in there as well. Gonna run a little bit of electrical tape around the around this part right here, this crimping job, just because don't want any moisture to get in there, or you know, obviously just keep it clean, keep it together. All right, guys, next what I'm gonna go ahead and do is just hook up this the positive wire to this fuse block right here, or this power supply. I don't want to run it to the battery. The instructions say to run it to the battery. I don't want to do that, so. It's going to be a 17 millimeter. Give you plenty of wire. That's good. Gonna route it, pre-route it already. Look at that, it fits pretty good. All right, awesome. Okay, guys, I'm gonna run this ground wire right here. Gonna be a 13 mil. Okay, guys, so I went ahead and took off the cover, and I'm just aiming it down towards the fuse box inside the engine bay. But listen, guys, this isn't for every Duramax, all right? So make sure you check your fuse block. In my particular case, I got an 07. This will correlate for an 06 as well. Ignition. All right, we're going to want to tap into the ignition fuse. So I'm going to go ahead and pull this one. So I'm going to be removing this one. And then I'm going to go ahead and install my add-a-fuse. So this and this one. Okay guys, so what I did, I went ahead and just dropped that existing wire. It goes to the pump, and what I'm gonna do now is just route it through the frame. So, you know, do this at your own discretion, guys. I'll be using a lot of zip ties and whatnot to do this, so. Okay, so at the very end, you're gonna wanna go ahead and just plug in the wiring harness to the actual lift pump. And at this point, guys, I'm not gonna video all this, but I'm gonna go ahead and clean up my mess, all my wiring. So I'm gonna mount the relay, clean up the wiring, but you guys get the general idea. So that's kind of what I was pointing out. Okay, with the Sump Kit, make sure you use some threading tape as well. Tighten it up pretty good, that fitting. And then you're gonna have this little O-ring inside there as well. And just make sure you guys lubricate that up a little bit. I'm just gonna use a little bit of oil. Nothing fancy, you know, just it's always good to lubricate these O-rings. Just a little bit of oil. Should be fine. Like that. And one thing to note, you're gonna have your drain plug on there as well. It's gonna come with that. You're obviously gonna have your bolt, your single bolt right here, and then this piece. So let's go ahead and get this one on right here. Okay guys, so there's no real easy way of doing this. It's gonna get messy either way, but find the flattest spot on the tank, which I'm gonna say is right here in the lowest spot as well. Go ahead and take your saw, and once you drill, it's gonna start. You're gonna be leaking fluid everywhere. But let's go ahead and get to it. It's actually pretty strong too. Doesn't seem like it's gonna budge whatsoever. I tightened it pretty good. I'm not sure the foot pounds on that, guys. I apologize, but I tightened it pretty tight. Yeah, it's on there really good, nice and tight. Let's keep moving. Let's get those lines on.
All right, guys. So I just want to cover this really quickly. Just a few tools that you'll need for the job that doesn't come with the kit. This is a line disconnect. Set right here. It was only like $5 just for like a cheap one or whatever, but invest into something like this. It's probably gonna be your best bet. You're really not gonna be able to pull those fuel lines off without them. In this case, you'll be using a half inch for this setup, but anyways, next what you'll need is you know, just to cut your hose, obviously. So you're gonna need some cutters for that, and don't skimp, man. Guys, don't use your kitchen scissors or, you know, just something cheap that you have laying around to cut this hose with, because you're probably not going to get the best cut, and you want a nice straight cut. You know, it's really important. And this was only like $12, so really no big deal. I went ahead and got myself a few more of these guys, and then also I bought like a barb fitting half inch, with a little cap screw on the tip of it. And the reason why I did that is because I'm doing the sump kit as well. I'm kind of doing both together. You know, once I disconnect the fuel line, it's going to be wide open, okay? So I'm going to need to cap that off with something. So I went ahead and bought a half-inch barb fitting. So I suggest you guys do the same thing. I think it's a great idea. And then, you know, obviously put your clamp around, you know, once you get it all together, put your clamp around there and tighten it down. So
obviously those are the back tires. Here's the rear diff. So you go up, you just keep going, following the tank, and then you're going to see this. It's called a fuel cooler. Right here, this piece. Okay, that's the fuel cooler. And then you just go on up. And then right there is going to be the lines that you're going to be disconnecting. Okay? You guys get it? It's exactly where it's at, right there. That's what we'll be doing. That's where we'll be hooking stuff up at.
Okay, so we'll be using our half-inch fitting. Okay guys, so I just disconnected it. Sorry I didn't get it on video, me actually disconnecting the two lines. I knocked the camera over, so. But either way, pretty simple, half inch fitting. You will go ahead and just slide it through and it'll pop right out. Okay guys, so that's going to your E port side of your FASS. So go ahead and just put a little bit of oil on there. I'm just lubricating it a little bit. Go ahead and put on your clamp. And what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm gonna size this stuff without cutting it. I'm going to go ahead and just plug it in and then size it and then cut it. Okay, that way, they always say measure twice, cut once. That's I'd say my best bet there. All right. Just like that. And again, that's going to your E side, and just tighten up your clamps. Okay, so again, plug it in, you'll hear a click, but you know, you got to use two hands on this one and really push them in tightly. But you can see I haven't hooked up to that factory clip right here. I routed it through there, and then I'm routing it over the frame, and then I'm gonna go ahead and plug it in to this top one right here. Okay. And then the bottom one is the return, and the return is going to plug in to this spout right there. Okay guys, so next I'm going to go ahead and build my cap for that suction line that went to the top of the gas tank, or the fuel tank. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to attach these two barbed fittings together, and then just plug this into the existing fitting that we disconnected. So. Don't really need much. That's about right. Put a little oil on the tip of it. Make sure it's nice and tight. And then this is going to be the end piece here. Alright, so that's what it's going to look like, okay guys? And all I'm going to do is just plug it in and zip tie it up so it doesn't go nowhere.
Okay guys, so went ahead and just zip tied it right there. The existing suction line that I don't need anymore. That way no fuel leaks out of it.
Okay guys, now I'm routing my my tank hose. It's on there pretty tight. Let me show you.
What I did is routed it over.
It's really hard to see, but you guys get the idea. There's a little indent in the tank right here. There's a little slot to route it through. And it goes on down there. And then all I'm gonna do is just plug it into the sump right here. So I just need to cut off what I need and put it right through.
There it is. Now, obviously I'm gonna clean up the lines, the fuel hoses. I'm gonna tighten them up a little bit and zip tie everything.
All right, here it goes.
All right guys, so basically what I did is I went ahead and just loosened the fuel filter a little bit, turned the starter over, let the pump motor actuate, and then obviously the fuel flowed into the filter itself from the suction side, pushing the fuel inside the fuel filter. Since the fuel filter was already cracked open, the reason why I did that is because I wanted the fuel filter to be full of fuel and then basically to shoot out of the fuel filter and then tighten it. That way there's no air in the system. That's why I did that. So probably not the most preferred method, but that's just how I did it. Another way you guys can do this so it's not so messy is just go ahead and fill the fuel filter with diesel fuel and then just go ahead and tighten it back up in there. So now that we're done, we're gonna go ahead and start the truck.
Off the bat, I can tell just by the sound of it, it started up a lot quieter. A lot quieter. Interesting. So, yeah. I'll go ahead and let it run for a couple minutes. And we're going to go ahead and check for leaks as well. So with these fuel filters, guys, just like an oil filter, just make sure they're hand tight, or a fuel, you know, the other fuel filter on the other side of the truck. But just make sure that these are all hand tight. Okay, don't over tighten these things.
Okay, so I'm completely done, and let me show you. I'm gonna do just a quick run through, and you guys can always rewind it, go back to the part where I went into the electrical. That one's pretty straightforward. And you know, this is too, obviously, but the fuel filter, you change that out every 15,000 miles. Okay, it's recommended by FASS. The water separator, you change that out every 30,000 miles. Okay, so that's the recommendation for that. Guys, I'm just gonna do just a quick walkthrough on this just so we don't forget anything or miss anything and miss a step. So the bottom hose line right here is connected to the return. Okay. The return is going back into your tank, which that big tube right there is your return. It's called your filler neck, okay, where I installed that spout. That's where the tube will connect. The fuel line will connect from here to that spout, okay? And then this is gonna be your suction line, and the suction line is connected to, like where I showed you guys, right here, let me show you. Right there, okay, and that's actually the suction line that's connected, that's going to your engine, so you guys are tracking that. And then, you know, obviously I capped this piece off right here, like I was talking about, the existing fuel line that I didn't need because I'm using a sump. Now if you don't hook up the actual sump kit, you will need that line. That line right there is gonna hook up to your tank, which is on the opposite side. It's gonna hook up right there. Okay, so now that I have the sump, it's routed to the lift pump. All right, guys, to my sump kit, where I drilled that hole in the tank. All right, I know you guys can see that I put some sealant around it. There's a reason for that. You know, it's been about 2 days and it started leaking on me. It actually leaked on me the very first time I put fuel in it. Once I got to about 3 gallons, it started leaking, which really wasn't a lot of fun. So what I did is I pulled it down. I inspected the O-ring. What I did, I actually tightened the O-ring too tight. That's what did that right there. So I think I might have flattened it. So I went ahead and went online, did some research, and one of the guys recommended RTV, the blue kind, the sealant that you can buy like at any auto parts store. So that's what I went with. So what I did is I just caked a bunch of this stuff. I obviously had to drain the diesel fuel out, which really was not fun. And my wife didn't appreciate it much because it was getting all over our driveway. But what I went ahead and did is just drop this down, caked up a bunch of the RTV sealant, pasted it back up there, screwed it down, let it dry overnight. Actually, it's only a 1 hour dry time, but I came back the very next day, filled it up with diesel fuel, and I have not had a leak since. And this has been 2 days now. No problems, no worries whatsoever. So that was my biggest headache right there. That was not fun. But yeah, overall, guys, hopefully that answered some of your questions. You know, about exactly how to directly install this stuff. Pretty simple. The wiring harness in itself, pretty straightforward, as I was saying. Just if you need to, rewind back to the old video so you guys can get a better idea on how I ran that.
All right, guys, installation complete. I am so excited about this, man. Took me about, I'd say about 3 hours, but the average guy, the average garage, I don't know, average tools, really, can get this job accomplished. So you don't have to be a genius to do this. This is actually pretty simple. It just sucks. I'd say the worst part is just dealing with that fuel, disconnecting those lines above the cooler. That wasn't very fun. And then obviously drilling a hole in my gas tank. So if you guys don't actually do the sump kit, which I highly recommend, if you guys don't do that, where I actually cap that spot off, that suction line where I capped off, that's where you're actually gonna run your tank, okay? That hose, that single port on the right side of your lift pump is actually going to that actual fuel line, that existing fuel line. That's where it's gonna go. Just to answer your question for you guys who are like, what if I don't run a sump? That's where that existing line goes. Okay, so just make sure you understand that. But hey, overall, super pumped. I'm driving it right now after I got the lift pump done. I actually kind of been getting on a little bit before I turned the video on. And I'm telling you, throttle response is definitely, I can tell a difference. It's steady, man. It, like, when I get on it, it just stays in it, man. It really does. There's no sort of lag. Like, I mean, you know, obviously there might be a slight turbo lag, but it's really steady in the throttle. It feels great, man. I mean, I could bury the gas pedal right now, and it feels really stiff and really nice. Also, I'm not rolling as much coal as I used to, and that's a good thing, by the way. Some of you guys that I know that I even asked the question, you know, hey, if I put a lift pump in my truck, will I blow more black smoke? No, the answer is no. And, I thought the reason why is because you're introducing fuel quicker, more efficiently into the ejection rails. So I'm thinking, you know, obviously the injectors are trying to keep up with the amount of fuel, so I might get under the turbo and blow a little more coal or roll a little more coal than normal. But super impressed, super excited. I got more to do. I'm not done yet with this truck. I need you guys to continue to watch my video. Guys, okay, just some quick shout outs to some of the Duramax channels that are out there. Some of you guys are doing just some amazing things. I'm actually watching your videos as well, and getting a better idea. So check out Paul right here. All right, he's doing some really amazing things. He actually just did an injector cleaning video, so that might be really beneficial to you. He's just starting out just like I am, so check out his video. Also, I want you guys to check out LML Mike. This guy's amazing. His truck is super clean, by the way. Here's a few of his videos, okay? I don't know if you guys can see that. But LML Mike, this guy, I'll tell you what, he's got a really nice truck. And for some of you guys have the newer body style, well, I don't want to say a new body style, but the one before that, you know, check him out as well. Also, guys, check out Project Duramax. He's got a pretty cool channel, so stop by him as well. I want you to check out JW Montoya. All right, you're killing it, man. You're doing some really good stuff on YouTube as well. But hey, other than that, apologize if I missed some of you guys. But you know, if
if you like the video, make sure you hit that like button, please. And hey, do not forget to subscribe. You know, obviously I'm doing a lot of videos on this Duramax right here. I always appreciate your guys' support, and you guys have a great day.